Gravity seems very familiar. After all, it's what makes stuff fall, it's what keeps the planets in their orbits. But thinking about the fundamental physics of gravity has led scientists to question the very existence of space and time. This is because gravity is very different from the other forces. So why is gravity so unique? I'm Jared Kaplan, and this is Why is Gravity Different? You may know that there are four fundamental forces: electromagnetism, the weak force, the strong force, and also, of course, gravity. The electromagnetic force is responsible for the interactions of charged particles, for magnetism, and holding electrons in their atoms. The weak and strong nuclear forces are responsible for subatomic processes and for holding protons and neutrons together. To understand these three fundamental forces, we take a reductionist approach. We take matter apart into its most fundamental constituents and then watch those constituents interact. The enormous particle accelerators that physicists use are really like giant microscopes. So why do we build big particle accelerators that use high energies? It's because of Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. To see small stuff, we need big energies. It might seem like gravity is very similar to the other forces. After all, the orbits of the planets around the sun were an inspiration for the idea that electrons orbit atomic nuclei. But in fact, gravity is very different from the other forces. Gravity gets stronger and stronger and stronger as you increase the energy of your accelerator. So that if you were to try to probe gravity at a fundamental level, all you do is make a black hole. And that black hole would destroy your microscope. So we have to study gravity a bit differently. Our best theory of gravity is Einstein's theory of general relativity, which famously says that the gravitational force is due to the curvature of space-time. Fortunately, the very existence of black holes points to a new way of thinking about quantum gravity. We had the first hint of a major revolution when in 1972, Jacob Bekenstein argued that the total information inside a black hole is actually proportional to the surface area of the black hole and not to its volume. But why is this such a surprising and revolutionary insight? So if information is stored on areas rather than in volumes, perhaps the laws of physics should be formulated in fewer space-time dimensions. Why would we think something so surprising and crazy? Well, let's take a step back and think about information. Fundamentally, information is a description of the state or the configuration of the universe. On a practical level, we can think of it in terms of a hard drive. Hard drives store information with tiny little magnets, and the more magnets you have, the more information you have. But that means that information should scale with the volume of our hard drive. But what happens if our hard drive falls into a black hole? The information on the hard drive won't be lost. Instead, it will be encoded in the state of the black hole. Yet, if the total amount of information a black hole can hold is proportional to its surface area, it means that actually that intuitive volume scaling law of our hard drive was wrong. This says that volume, which is essentially space itself, isn't fundamental. In other words, the fundamental theory of gravity should have fewer dimensions. The area law challenges many very basic principles. It calls into question whether stuff can interact with nearby stuff via forces. This leads to a new way of thinking about physics, where the universe is a hologram. Just as a hologram provides a three-dimensional image from a two-dimensional plate, the fundamental description of our universe could be lower dimensional, while we experience an illusory three-dimensional world. Applying this idea to black holes, we can look at the information in the lower dimensional theory of physics to unpack the information in the black hole. So because black holes would break our microscope, we can't study quantum gravity in the same way that we studied the other fundamental forces. But fortunately, black holes have provided us with a way to think about gravity on a quantum level.